Thanks all of you for being so late here. I'm so tired. It was a hard day, but I'm so happy to be here after Cesare's presentation. I think it was so visionary. I love that. There are two reasons I'm so happy. First, because of this clarity in answering and responding to the, I would say, a little bit harsh editorial that we received. And the second one, I have a very similar presentation at the FUJIFILM symposium at DDW. So I will copy and paste the presentation of Cesare. Cesare, where you are? I need your presentation for the DDW symposium, so I don't need to work for next couple of weeks. So now let's go to the topic of advanced tissue resection. This is EMR and ESD. They are very similar in terms of what we want to get. We want to remove early neoplasia. If it is low grade or high grade, we can do piecemeal. If we have the suggestion of a little bit more advanced histology, we should remove and block. So what they have in common is the fact that we need a submucosal injection to create a sort of safety cushion to remove the lesion. So the EMR and ESD, they may be a little bit technically different, but in common they have that we have to get started with submucosal injection. So when we talk about submucosal agents, we have to take care of a couple of easy concepts. First, the solution must be very easy to inject. We don't need solutions that are very hard to be pushed by the syringe, or we don't need any solution that require additional tool for being injected in the submucosa. And also, it must provide a nice cushion that lasts for a little bit longer than saline, and should also be helpful in identifying the margins of the lesion, and finally, should not provide any tissue damage. You know, in the past there has been a couple of different submucosal injectable solutions that have been tested both in animals and humans, and the histology has been proved that they were creating a huge phlogistic reaction, so to preventing the proper histologic examination. So if you look there in the last 40 years, we had a sort of big change in the game of submucosal injection. So all of you is aware that we started with polyp resection, I would say saline-assisted polypectomy. We moved to a little bit more viscous because we realized that we need a substance that was staying longer than saline into submucosa. And at the beginning of 2000, we had the explosion of EMR and ESD. From the Japanese masters of ESD, we started using the hyaluronic acid. And afterwards, we moved to a little bit a cheaper solution because hyaluronic acid wasn't available in Europe, but most of all, it was extremely expensive. And now in 2017, last year, we got this new solution approved by FDA and also with the CE mark. So what are the limitations? So we know that saline doesn't work for a long time, but also there are other problems. When we use a short-acting solution, we need to reinject a lot. This takes time, and if we don't select the right agent, we may cause some injection site damage or inflammation that can create problems either during the resection or at the histopathology examination. And finally, everybody has his own recipe in preparing his own viscous solution, so it takes time. You have all the time to remind to your nurse what you have to mix up, methylene blue, indigo carmine, any kind of gel, plus adrenaline or minus adrenaline. So this is extremely variable. It's not reliable in terms of technique of approach to ESD or EMR. So these are confidential data that I took from the company marketing the Eleview in the United States. If you look what is the amount of saline still amount of patients have been still treated with the saline. You see that most of the polyp resection is still done in the United States with the saline injection, and also most of EMR. There is a change with ESD. When the Americans, they do ESD, mostly they use viscous solution. And of course, there is still some guys using the saline, especially because they are using the hybrid knife technology, which requires just a saline. So if you look to that, I think that there is an issue with EMR. So I think that for providing a good EMR procedure, we should use a longer lasting solution. So we have to switch a little bit from saline to more viscous. And this is a meta-analysis that we have published the last year. We looked at just two prospective paper comparing normal saline with more viscous solution, and we just found five prospective randomized trial. And if you can see the M block resection achieved in patients treated with more viscous solution, and also the residual lesion found at follow up was significantly better in the viscous solution arm as compared with the saline arm. So there is also a regulatory issue. So if you want to use an approved solution, SigmaVish is hyaluronic acid, which is approved in Europe, and the other hyaluronic acid approved is MugoApp, which is available, I believe, only in Japan, is not available in Europe and the United States. So now this is the solution provided by Eleview. It's ready to use. You have just to suck in your syringe. It's sterile. It's approved by FDA and CE marked. It's pre-mixed with the Madeleine Blue in order to improve lesion visibility during the time of resection. It's compatible with most of the devices that you are going to use for standard polyp resection or EMR. So we did the extensive test in our unit with our nurses when the solution was developed. It's as easy as a standard saline to be injected. And what are the chemical properties? You see different components of the Eleview, and the components are mixed up just to provide after injection a sort of hemispherical cushion that stay in place for a long time, and I will show some data about durability of the injection to provide a safer and very effective resection. So just two slides about durability. This was the first bench of tests that we have done in the lab against saline. And you see there is a huge difference in terms of disappearance of the cushion on the right side of the slide. And also we compared on ex vivo porcine stomach saline, Eleview, and MucoApp. And you see the results in terms of persistence of the cushion of Eleview is exactly the same of hyaluronic acid. So it's not hyaluronic acid, it's a polymer, it's easy to inject, it's cheaper than hyaluronic acid, but stays as well as the hyaluronic acid. And so this is the first ever injection that we have done. This is a historical video we have done in our unit in testing the solution. And can you go halfway to the video, please? Okay. You can do that?
There's no panel for it.
Okay, so can you
stop me?
Okay, go ahead. So you see, after injection was nice cushion. After the cut, you can see the submucosal cushion that was staying there. So it was very soft. So this one, we decided that was the right composition, chemical composition to be adopted and to be used for the animal safety test. So afterwards, after FDA approval, we worked on a prospective randomized trial comparing Eleview with the standard saline. These are the centers involved. The study was led by Doug Rex. We presented the last year at DDW. The paper is now accepted on GI endoscopy, so probably will be Available online within a couple of weeks. These are the endpoints that we have used for the study. Mostly we looked at the total injected volume, and we also looked at the time to resect, because we believe if we reduce the number of injection, because the solution is staying longer, we can reduce the operation time of EMR, and also we had a lot of safety endpoints to make sure that the solution was not affecting either the procedure or the patients. And these are the results. On the first row, there is the big difference in terms of total injection volume for lesion larger than 2 centimeters randomized. You see 100 patients in the Eleview, 109 in the reference comparator, the saline. So we used half of the volume in the saline. Also the time was significantly shorter. The operation time was significantly shorter than the saline arm. So this is the first live endoscopy use of Eleview. It's Pradeep.
The Fuji 700 system equipped with BLI.
Pradeep, you know that I'm very ignorant. What's the difference Cesare? Between device and BLI?
So to make sure that everybody
okay, there are
there.
Lots of differences. So this system works on LED light rather than the normal bulb that you see on your endoscope. Blue laser imaging system was the original one Fuji came out, but now they call it blue light imaging because it's not laser, it's using LED light. And the big difference between this BLI and all other optical enhancement techniques is there is no filter. So this gives you a genuine blue light at the wavelength at which the NBI produces with the filter. So you don't lose any quality of the picture. It's bright. And you can see, just look at the white light image.
So it's a long video.
I go up to the lesion. You can see the surface pattern so well, even just on the white light.
So just give you a couple of cases that we have done. This is a very recent case. It's a big sessile polyped hepatic flexure. You see it was quite big. This is under BLI. We always double check morphology, P pattern, and the vascular pattern. And you see the details. You don't need to go too much high with the optical zoom. You can appreciate very nice details both on P pattern and vascular pattern when using LCI. With LCI, you can go very deep in details. You can see a lot using the optical zoom. And this is the injection steps. So it's very important that the hepatic flexure that you protect the polyp resection from deep injury, especially I'm concerned of perforation. We know from previous study that in this part of the colon there is an increased risk of getting perforation, also having target sign, and this is an outpatient, so we need to inject carefully. That's the first point. We need to inject all around the lesion, and we need to see a very nice cushion. So this is an Eleview injection, and when we inject the blue solution, we can see there is also a flat part of the polyp. This is very important if we want to get hem block resection of this big polyp. You see this time we are injecting around 9:47. And you can see it's easy to inject, so the syringe, you cannot see the nurse pushing the solution of the syringe, but it's like injecting the saline, the standard saline. So now we can appreciate a very nice cushion. I went again on the other side to complete the injection. So it took a little while. So it's very important that you take your time when you make such a big resection. And I tried, my goal was to get the entire polyp in a single piece. So at this point, a large snare. You can see the nice elevation. One more. Normally I do 1 cc injection per site. You don't need too much because you get very nice elevation. And now the snare. So what I want to show you is you have to play a little bit to juggle with the snare to make sure that you are going down to the base. And we have a nice elevation and we resect the polyp. So now look, we are about 7 minutes later. So we are looking to the base of resection. We are using optical zoom. So we cannot appreciate the muscle, we cannot appreciate the muscular layer. So it means that there is a lot of submucosal solution. You can see the little bubbles. So there is still a lot of submucosal injection, submucosal agent injected there, staying for very long time. And this is very nice because it's helpful in preventing the risk also of delayed perforation. So I have one more video, but I want to skip. This is the last video. Okay, this is tough lesion that's been referred after previous partial resection. So again, all the time we go through this protocol, white light, BLI, LCI, from endoscopy, and we decided there was a lot of fibrosis, so we decided to do underwater. And one of the main area of research for us in advanced tissue resection altogether with Roberta Maselli is that we are doing underwater after Eleview injection, because do we believe that we are resecting such a fibrotic lesion, we need to elevate a little bit to avoid the risk of perforation. So we do underwater injection, you see, and after underwater, after injection, we start with resection with a small size snare. And it is extremely helpful, it's extremely fast. You can see that within a couple of minutes, we resected the entire lesion, and the results was beautiful. So we do believe that an additional indication for this solution is when you have a tough lesion with a lot of fibrotic reaction, either because of the fibrosis of the biopsies or previous resection, you can make a combination of Eleview injection and underwater resection. So you can provide a very fast but also very safe procedure, and this is the handle procedure with the lesion entirely removed. We just did APC at the borders to prevent early recurrence of the lesion. So this is the last slide to invite all of you to our next image.